First, the president obviously should have political appointees that he has faith and confidence in. He's meeting with the president, I think, tomorrow. So I think we shouldn't step in the way of that. We should let the president work it out with Rod Rosenstein. I hope they have a good, productive conversation, and I think that's helpful. I'll say it, I've said this all along, the special prosecutor, the special counsel, excuse me, should be free to complete his work. That goes without saying, and it should be free to complete its work without any political interference. I don't think he will be fired. I don't think the president is going to fire him. I don't think the president should fire him. Mueller, I'm talking about. Sorry, not Rosenstein, Mueller. I will defer to the Judiciary Committee. I don't micromanage the committees around here. I'll defer to the Judiciary Committee as to what kind of hearings they want to have, what kind of witnesses they want to have. But I would say this. If you're going to stack the credibility of Rod Rosenstein against Andy McCabe, who was fired for lying, I'll go with Rod Rosenstein. Well, I think that's what the hearing is about. First of all, I think that Chuck Grassley has handled this in a professional way. I think it's important that both are heard, the accuser and Judge Kavanaugh. I would say that the professional way that this has been treated by the Senate Judiciary Committee stands in stark contrast to the way the Senate Democrats have handled this, sitting on this for weeks, dropping it after the hearings to try and implode this nomination. So I think it's fitting and proper that they hear from both sides this week, and then I'll defer to the Senate on how and when to act.
Do you think there should have been a reopening?
No, I think they should do exactly what they're doing. I think they're doing a good job.